So the first thing that you're probably going to want to do is take all of the electronic PDF sources that you've already downloaded previously and you have scattered among your computer and flash disks and backup drives, what have you, and import them into Mendeley. And so there are several ways that you can do that. The first way that you can do it is you can simply just take your PDF and drag it into Mendeley. So here's an example. This is a PDF that I just downloaded, and I downloaded it from a database, and you'll notice that the title that it was given was contentserver.pdf. Now, I have no idea what that is, and if I see it within a folder of 80, 100, 200 PDFs, I really have absolutely no idea what that PDF is. So it's very simple. We just take the PDF and we drag it into the main space, and you'll see all of a sudden that all of the metadata has been pulled from the PDF and put into the appropriate spaces. And it does that by doing two different types of searches. First, it actually goes into the PDF itself and tries to glean some of the metadata from the PDF. Second is that Mendeley actually has an online system or an online repository that captures and saves all of the metadata for every PDF that's ever been uploaded by a Mendeley user. So that way, all of the metadata has already been uploaded and corrected. And for the reason I would assume that this went so easily and that all of the metadata went in perfectly is that someone already has this PDF stored into their Mendeley account, which automatically goes into their cloud service and it captures that metadata, the corrected metadata, and it matches up the title and all of the metadata information with what's stored in the cloud. And that way it's able to provide this particular accuracy with gleaning all of the metadata into the information on the right-hand side of the desktop page. So the PDF is, it's a journal article, and here's the title. And you notice that the title, the way it's already written, has the specific caps. They're not caps in terms of a title, so that way it fits the APA format. And I have all of the authors here, and that checks out perfect. And here's the journal, the year, the volume, the issue, the page numbers. It pulls all of the abstract information. It pulls the author keywords, and it pulls the URL from where everything is. And you'll also notice here down in the files section, because we opted to have all of the imports change the title based upon the author, the year, and the title, it has done that all of a sudden for us. Now all we have to do is just double click, and then the PDF is here for us. So the PDF is already in Mendeley. It's pulled out all of the metadata, and it's ready for our use to read and mark up. Now, generally what I would do is I would quickly go into this PDF and just double check to make sure all the metadata is correct, that the title completely matches, that the authors match. Sometimes during the import, sometimes the ordering of the authors can get switched. Making sure that the journal is correct, 2014, that looks correct. The volume, the number, the pages, that all looks right. And everything is checking out and it looks perfect. So this particular PDF was perfectly imported. Taking the time to make sure that the metadata matches the PDF and it's 100% accurate and clean takes a little bit of discipline and it takes a little bit of time up front, but I promise in the long run, it's gonna save you a ton of time, it's gonna save you a ton of hassle, and it's gonna keep you incredibly organized when it comes time to write the paper. Now, you don't necessarily have to pull in each PDF one by one. Let's say you have an entire folder full of PDFs. So in this example, I have a folder right here on our desktop labeled Research Sources. And just for this example, I pulled in four PDFs. And you notice here, once again, the titles, I have no idea what any of this means. They're just sort of thrown into this folder. And so I want to organize it. So if you have a folder or multiple folders on your desktop or stored anywhere, you can simply just use the entire folder. So the way I would go about doing that is I would go up to File, and I would go Add Files, and I would click on Add Files, and I would make sure to highlight each of these. So I'm clicking it, holding down Shift, and taking all of them, and I'm just gonna click Open, and you see that it quickly stores everything in here. So everything already now is taken from the folder and put into Mendeley. So what I wanna do once again now is make sure that everything got transferred in properly. So let's double click on this, and I'll zoom out just a little bit so we can get a good read on it. So you'll notice here that it says these details need reviewing. And so we want to just double check to make sure that everything looks right. So generally here, what I would do with the title is I would make sure that I have it cap appropriate. So that way when I cite it, everything is going to be cited properly according to basic APA style. And so the authors are correct. I can go through and I could change the names if I want. These are my colleagues, Stephanie and George. So that looks correct. Educational and Psychological Measurement, 2016, Volume 76, Issue 4, and the pages are correct. Now, if I want, what I can actually do, I can pull in all of this information from the abstract since it didn't get read. I could do a Control C and a Control V. Now I have everything in my abstract information. And once again, I have everything pulled up. It says the journal article, everything's correct. So I just say the details are correct. And I click correct and everything is there, ready to go. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. If you did, make sure to give us a big thumbs up and like the video. If you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe to our channel by clicking the link above, and make sure to check out some of our other videos. We'll see you again soon.